written down in glory. yes, it's mine.
But let's pray. Would you pray with me tonight? Dear Lord, we're so thankful to be in your house.
Lord, I'm excited for what I have already felt in my soul tonight. Thank you for revival. Thank you that you revive us.
Yes, God.
Lord, thank you that you breathe new life into us, spiritual life. And Lord, I'm asking you tonight, Lord, just do it again tonight. I believe that you are, because I already feel the blessings and the power of the Holy Ghost of God. And Lord, I ask you tonight to bless in this service. And Lord, I ask you to help Pastor Jim as he preaches tonight, Lord, comfort him and strengthen him and anoint him.
Yes, Lord.
And Lord, for Brother Mike and Brother Jim, they're singing the music, Lord, how anointed that is. Help them tonight, Lord, we pray. And Lord, thank you for all the people that are watching and will be watching. Lord, I pray that you told us your word would not go out void, but it would accomplish that which you please. And Lord, wherever it goes tonight, people that are watching now will be watching later. I pray that it'll be a blessing. Maybe somebody that's not saved, Lord, would be saved and ask Jesus into their heart. Somebody that's not sure would get sure.
Yes, Lord.
Somebody that's backslid would come back home. And Lord, people that are just struggling with all kinds of issues, Lord, I pray that, Lord, Jesus is the answer. Lord, bless these folks that we called out tonight, that we mentioned, God, I pray that you touch them and help them and heal them. And Lord, give us a great, great service in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
All right, Brother Mike, I'm stirred up. Man.
Amen. He does get stirred up. That word directly, I think that's an Arkansas word.
Is it? Directly.
No, God's good to us. Well, even before I got saved, I was traveling with a gospel quartet playing bass guitar and guitar for them. My brother-in-law was one of the leaders in that group named Paul Payne. He's watching that.
He's watching.
And I observed their life and watched them while we were on the road. And it was because of the testimony they had in Jesus Christ. I actually saw Jesus lived out in them. And I got to hear preaching, and I got to hear music in that year that I traveled with them, even before I became a Christian. And then one night, at a concert that I was playing at, during the intermission time, I got saved. And I just thank God for that moment. But there was a song that I learned early on, and I've heard Dave sing it a lot, I've heard Rob sing it quite a bit, and it's entitled, I Believe an Appeal Call. Calvary. I believe in that. I believe what Jesus did for you and I on the cross. I believe that he gave his life as a ransom for me. And he paid a price for my life that I couldn't even pay for on the cross. Tonight we're going to sing this song. I just pray you follow along and God bless you as we sing.
I believe whatever ourselves a fit right here in the auditorium of Freedom Baptist Church. And you know what? I've been telling folks that, you know, when we started this, we didn't know how it was going to go. But I'm going to tell you what, God has blessed. And the power and the blessings of God, man, are just evident around us again tonight. We're excited. We've got our other pastor, Freedom Baptist Church, is blessed to have two guys like Pastor Mike Brooks, Pastor Jim Canucki, on staff here. I'm blessed to have them. They are a tremendous blessing to me. They both have over 40 years in the ministry. Pastor Jim does the children's youth ministry. He's a little bit old, but I'm going to tell you what, you've never seen anybody that loves kids like he and his wife, Tanya. And I'm going to tell you what, they are a blessing. They love these kids, and the kids love them. And you didn't see the pregame show. He had one of his puppets out, brought over to put on the show. But I want you to pray tonight. We're honored to have our pastor, Jim Canucki, with us. Brother Jim, come preach tonight. God bless you, brother.
Amen.
Thank you. Oh, man, we'll do that. I was going to do that. Carry away.
All right. Well, I just have to say, I am glad I'm out of lockdown. I guess that's a lot better than being locked up, amen? But I have to say this. I don't know how much time I have, but I just want to say that I am so thrilled to be at church. I'm telling you, preacher said it, God just shows up. And certainly, I tell you, he's here, he's in the house.
He's in the house.
And I thank God. And I want to just take a couple of seconds. I don't have a long message, but I just want to thank the Lord for Brother Jim and his talent that he has given to the Lord, playing that piano. And I tell you what, it's a blessing from my heart. And him, I love him and his dear wife. And I think last night and all this week, and hearing people and hearing Brother Brooks preach, and what can I say about Brother Brooks? I love him and the Lord, and what a preacher and what a singer, and just a servant of the Lord. I am so glad for his testimony, and God saved him out of this. God bless him. And then our preacher, I'll tell you one, it's been a long while back, and I heard preacher for the very first time get up, and I was sitting in the back row of a church, and he let it out, and I'm saying, I'm sitting there, and God just showed up when he started preaching, and it come over me, and I said, man, we're having church now. And all of a sudden, people looked at me like I must have said a cuss word or something. But it, and you know what? Ever since he preached that first sermon that I heard, he's never changed what I heard. He's been the same. He's been on fire. I almost brought a fire extinguisher in tonight, not to put him out, but in case he catches the place on fire, we need to put it out so we have a place to come. I thank God. Anyway, I want to preach to you tonight. Just a short message. We're talking about revival. And Lord, I'm telling you what, it's a wonderful thing to be in revival. When 22 people met at Uncle Sam's place.
Yeah.
And I want to tell you, God, excuse me, God showed up on that Sunday. We didn't know where to go or what to do. And the man of God stood there in tears, said, I'm going to follow what God wants us to do. And I have to give credit where credit's due and thank God for Brother Brooks, who walked around this place seven times.
Right.
And claimed it for the Lord Jesus. And God has sent to this place. And from the very first time, first moment that we stepped on this property, God showed up.
Amen.
And he's not left us. One service, every service, he's been in here to empower our preacher. I'm just thrilled to death. Tonight I want to preach a little bit. It won't take long, but I want to preach on some things that cannot be shaken. If you go to Hebrews chapter 12 and verse 27, the Apostle Paul says, there and this word yet once more signifieth the removing of those things that are shaken as of the things that are made, that those things which cannot be shaken may remain. The Apostle Paul, in his time he ran in, had a lot of churches. He dealt with people. And there was a lot of things that had to be shaken for God to be able to work in that particular church. And it's the same way across America today. God has to shake some things up to get people back to the Almighty God. That's not my message tonight on things that need to be shaken. There's a lot of things that need shaking. I think God's shaking America right now as we go through this this virus, and over 70,000 people have lost their life. And yet, they need to cry out to God. But I'm not saying that the things that should be shaken is the United States and homes and churches and preachers and backslidden Christians. That's not my message tonight. My message I want you to hear tonight, listen, Christian, if you're like the Apostle Peter and you stepped out of the boat and you start walking on water and you got your eyes on Jesus, and all of a sudden he took his eyes off of Jesus and began to fall down into the water. If we'll keep our eyes on the Lord Jesus Christ through this pandemic and through this virus and through the things that's going on, keep your eyes on the Lord Jesus Christ. There are some things that cannot be shaken. Number one, if you're taking notes, number one, God cannot be shaken. He is the one great, omnipotent, unchangeable being. In all of eternity's past, in all of things present, in all of eternity's future, God remains the same. We don't know how long it's been since God spoke the world into existence, but God was the same then as he is right now and shall be forevermore. The Hebrews says that Jesus is the same today, yesterday, and today, and forever. Our preacher said this past week that, did it ever occur to you that nothing occurs to God? God knows everything. He didn't get up this morning and said, oops, I don't know what to do. He always has known what to do. Amen. He started it out and he'll end it. Number two, God's word will never be shaken.
Amen.
The Bible says, forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven, in Psalms 119:89. The Bible says, the grass withereth and the flowers fadeth, but the word of our God shall stand forever. Isaiah chapter 40, verse 8. The Bible says, heaven and earth shall pass away, but my word shall never pass away, in Matthew 24, verse 35. Listen to me tonight, church. The Bible has always been under attack. Every year you have new translators, like the ones that come up with the NIV, the non-inspired version. God, listen, I'm so glad I'm not following the Bible of the Month Club. I'm going to stick with the King James. It was good enough to get me saved. It was good enough to keep me saved. It was good enough to lead my family to Christ and many others. It's the book that God has for us today. You say, are you an idiot to believe that? Yes, I am. Thank you very much. Number three, God's Son. I couldn't wait to get to it. God's Son will never be shaken. His character can never be shaken. I'm sitting in my office in my little cubbyhole thinking about this last night, and his character can never be shaken. The sinless Son of God, his power can never be shaken. In Matthew 28, verse 18, he says, and Jesus came and spake unto them, saying, all power. How much? He said, all power is given unto me in heaven and in earth. Let me tell you tonight, church, nobody killed Jesus. If you'll read in John chapter 10 and verse 18, it says there, he said he had power to lay down his life.
Amen.
And he had power to raise it up again. He has power that has never been shaken. Aren't you glad tonight we have a Savior that cannot and will never be shaken. Listen, you can have revival with keeping in mind that God's not going to be shaken. His word's not going to be shaken. His son's not going to be shaken.
Amen.
But listen to me tonight, church. Number four, God's church shall never be shaken. The Bible says in Matthew 16 and verse 18, he said, upon this rock, that rock is Jesus, I will build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Pretty powerful, if you ask me. The Lord, the church of the Lord Jesus Christ, has a solid foundation. It is stuck in the rock of ages. Jesus is the foundational stone. Because the church, if the church ever fails, that means that Jesus himself would have to fail. It'll never happen. The church, God has always had his people, always had a remnant. Thank God for Freedom Baptist Church is that remnant. And number five, if you're taking notes, again, this is the last one, is that God's purpose can never be shaken. God has a plan. It's plan A. God has never had a plan B to get people saved. It's always been plan A. And that plan is Luke chapter 19 and verse 10. The Bible says the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost. That's God's plan. There's other churches that have changed that plan, and now they've replaced it with programs and plays and popularity contests. But that's not what the Son of God had in plan. He came to seek and to save that which is lost. I'm so glad that Jesus loved people enough to go through what he did on the cross to bring man to a saving redemption as he did. My wife and I did a little research study on Jesus when he was at the whipping post and tied to the whipping post. And as my mind goes back to the different movies they had on TV that never really showed exactly how Jesus suffered. But they said that suffering was the worst. Many men had died at the whipping post, was literally cut in half. And I thought, as I thought about all these things that cannot be shaken, I think of our Christ who was nailed tied to that post as those Roman soldiers whipped his back. And the only thing that was shaken was his hands from all the pain that he was going through. And those hands was reaching out to you and I.
Amen.
And saying, I love you. And I'm doing this for you. And I'm going to leave this spot. And I'm going up to Mount Calvary. And I'm going to allow them to lay me down on that cross. And I'm going to lay down my life for the people. And listen tonight.
Yes.
If you want to get in on something, 48 years ago, I got in on this.
Amen.
I was in the house of the people that had this church, and they were interested in my soul. And they poured out their heart to me that night. And I didn't know what I needed. I didn't know it was called being under conviction. I didn't know all those terminologies. I just knew something was really bad in my heart. And for the first time, as Brother Brooks has said, he had to realize he was lost. I saw myself for the very first time.
Man.
So lost. And so dirty. And I needed something.
Amen.
And those guys said, you need the Savior. I said, I know one thing. I need prayer. And I slid down off that couch onto that floor. And I was a yo-yo and snot and crying and everything. I'm telling you what God got a hold of my heart.
Amen.
I know it's real. It's been real for 48 years. I've never looked back. I've failed the Lord many times, and I've sinned, and I've done things I should have not done, and God looked at me and said, I still love you. I want to help you. Mm-hmm. And I've had people like our pastor, Brother Brooks, and different ones encouraged my heart. Through all these times that you get down, you get out. Listen, church, I'm telling you, revival, you've got to stick to it. You've got to stay in there. Don't let the virus, don't let people, don't let the critics, don't let anybody keep you from serving God. Amen. I believe the finish line is just out there. And
yes.
Just keep on going and trusting God.
Yes.
And doing what he said to get people saved. Mm. Listen, tonight, if you're not saved, oh, I beg you, I plead with you, please ask Jesus Christ. Our preacher gave a tremendous plan of salvation just this past week. My wife has sent out to Facebook friends and stuff. Listen, you need to take heed to that and listen to the man of God and how to be saved. It's not just a prayer 1, 2, 3 and you're in. You need to have conviction. You need to have what preacher was talking about.
Amen.
And ask Christ to come in your heart. To forgive you of your sins. And you know, he's ready to make the first step if you'll make your first step to come. Mm-hmm. Thank you, church. I love you, Pastor, Brother Mike.
Wow, I tell you, what a message. Did you hear Jesus talking to your heart tonight? that just tugged at my heart. And tonight, just as that call just went out to you, you may be in great need tonight. You may be lost and need a Savior. As we sing this song, I encourage you to go to the Lord just to ask him to forgive you of your sin, to come into your heart, make you a new creature. Maybe you've been saved, but you know you're not where you should be, and Jesus, right now is a great time to make it right. You go to him now as we sing. God bless you tonight. Revival's here. Do you feel it? Do you sense it? God's here. Let's sing this song. Calvary covers it all. Sing with me.
Atone and
good message, great message from Pastor Jim on things that cannot be shaken. And I just want to say to you tonight, if you're listening, you've been watching, if you'll watch later on record, please open your heart up to Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I mean, I'm blessed to be the pastor here and to get to know Pastor Brooks and Pastor Panucci and their testimony. And man, their testimonies are moving. It's what Jesus can do in somebody's heart. And as I was sitting there listening to Pastor Jim finish up, I believe a lot of people have head knowledge, but they don't have heart knowledge. That it's never been in the heart. You talk to folks, and they know all the right answers, but they've never truly given their heart to Jesus. I would ask you tonight, please, if you're not saved, would you just open your heart? Realize you're lost. I thought as he was preaching, you got to realize you're lost. And boy, when you stand before an almighty God, it's not going to be hard to realize you're lost if you're not saved. And I'm going to ask you tonight, please open your heart. Just bow your head. Say a simple prayer. Ask Jesus to come into your heart. Recognize that you're a sinner, and he'll save you. If you're backslidden away from God, I'm asking you to come home. That's what revival is. Come home. Come home. If you've got problems, come home. Bring them to Jesus. We've got a slide up behind me that, you know, if you prayed and asked Jesus into your heart, you rededicated your life, you come back to Jesus, let us know. It's encouragement to us. But, man, thank you. Thank you for being on. And I'm glad we got Pastor Jim out of hibernation, aren't you? I mean, man, we've had him on lockdown, man. But like you said, not locked up. Got to make sure we differentiate between lockdown and locked up. But, man, we got him out of hibernation. Got him here tonight. And thank you so much. Thank you for the music, Brother Brooks, Brother Jim. I'm telling you, it's been an absolutely great night. We're going to have another great night tomorrow night. Major Mike will be here. And that'll be Mike, and Mike. So, y'all don't have your mics when you get on. But if you're watching, maybe we'll get another mic or two around. But anyhow, I hope you have a great evening. We've had a great time. May God bless you. We love you. We're going to pray. Dear Lord, thank you for the service. Thank you for your power, for your fire, for your excitement, for your zeal. Lord, for the songs we heard tonight, Lord, for the message we heard. Lord, stir our hearts and help us, Lord, to get busy about your business. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. God bless you. We love you.